when I speak about the Migrant Solidarity Network, Mutual Aid Network, I really want to speak about the power of people, what people did, what your regular neighbors did, how DC community members just came together, different grassroots group, or just people, you know, who heard that people were doing welcoming migrants, just showed up when, again, the government was not doing anything, right? They just showed up, they dropped everything else, and they just welcomed people that they'd never met in their life before and made sure that they have clothes. I mean, sometimes a child comes out of the bus with no shoes and just a shirt on. This is right downtown in DC, and sometimes people haven't eaten in days, and so you want to make sure that you want to welcome them in the most humane ways. You know, you don't want to further harm as much as possible. You want to make sure that their transition to their end location is as smoothly as possible. I'm the founder of the first free store with the Peace House. We didn't even use the word mutual aid because I had no clue there was a word for it at that time. We also founded something called the Free School. So we went from organizing, protesting, and realizing that we must just use our natural abilities and gifts and tools that was already inside of us to benefit our community with projects and programs like a free school, a free store, a free market. And that is our focus. And, you know, we focus on farming, we focus on how can we get free food to our community and the necessary, you know, resources that our community needs to survive. And that's how the free store actually started. We were just three brown girls, very poor, and we had absolutely no income, and we were walking around rich neighborhoods in DC, looking around what people were throwing out that we can still use, and we would just collect them and created the first free store, just purely out of survival. And then we were like, other people probably could use the same thing, and that's how we started. We have never received government funding, and we won't.
Is there a reason why?
We are very grassroots. We believe in people power in the community. We have never had much, any trust, to be frank, in the government, and we don't believe that the government will or can save us. It's interesting because first I must say, folks who are impacted must do the work. If it's someone who is just like, I just took a bunch of classes, I just read about all these radical names and figures in the history, and that's why I'm interested. Cool, but it's not going to be as impactful as those who are impacted who can lead the work. That's really important. And those are the people who will stay in the community. You know, they will have also the same process. There is no written up how to do it all, and there really isn't. Everyone needs to find their way. And I've met younger, newly arrived activists a year ago, 2 years ago, that I don't see anymore. I know there's going to be further precautions and side effects of what the government is doing, because the government is doing things differently, right? The community is doing things differently. So the government is now slowly stepping in. However, the work is shifting, right? When the government steps in, as you can imagine, right? The government has regulations and rules where they want to do the things the way they want to do the things. And eventually, we must wait and see how that works out, because we know how the government operates, and then we must see what our roles and goals are after that.